Hello, this is Edith Neumeyer. I'm the author of the book, The Mystery of Adam. Well, I want to finish up my talk on complementarianism versus egalitarianism. And, you know, I have already said that I don't want to talk, you know, a whole bunch about this because I believe complementarians are just following false leaders. And sometimes when people do that, you just can't reach them. I mean, you can argue with them, you can show them things, you can show them all kinds of proof, but you can't convince them. I have listened to many things, you know, on YouTube about, you know, different things like not just complementarianism, but downright men that and women. That just believe that there is a hierarchy and that just men, women are on the bottom and men on top. The thing about hierarchy, people, is that if there's a hierarchy, we are all in the hierarchy. And only the top dog is on top. Okay? Like, for instance, a church. We have the pastor, the elders on top. And on the bottom is everybody else, including men. Now, of course, a woman just can't go up to the top of the, you know, food chain, as I call it, but on top of the hierarchy. But then again, my question is, do I want that as a woman to be on top of this hierarchy? A hierarchy that is wrong, that is absolutely wrong. I mean, do I want that? Do I even want to stay in a church that is hierarchically organized? And I'm saying, no, I don't want that. Now, I attend a church, a traditional Presbyterian church, but I don't want to become a member because I don't agree. Again, I don't agree with the hierarchy. Now, I could say, oh, yeah, you know, in my church, I could actually become a pastor, a woman pastor. And we have women pastors in the church that I attend. But do I want to become part of a church like that? And I'm saying, really, no. Why? Because the hierarchy is not the way the church should be organized. Now, we had that hierarchy creeping into the church for a long time. Actually, probably mainly from the beginning. I don't think it was not Jesus' intent for hierarchy to exist in the body. We read so many things that what Jesus said, we are supposed to serve one another. Okay, now again, we see that in the early church, it looks almost like that these apostles or some apostles like Peter, John, James, that they were leading the congregation. But I'm not so sure, again, if they were leading as much as if they people just looked up to them. Well, because people were not used to really having an egalitarian church. Okay, where all members are equal parts. And then we have Paul, who made it very clear that in the church, the church is a body with every member being equal and being of equal value. And so we can read his letters and we need to keep that in mind. But very soon after Paul, hierarchy did creep into the church. And so by the time Constantine united the church, I guess they were willing they were accepting the fact that one person, Constantine, would take over the church and would kind of regulate the church. There were lots of strife and division in the church before Constantine took over. And so Constantine showed that he was interested in uniting the churches. And so maybe that's why a lot of people kind of went along with it. A lot of the bishops Because even in those days, you know, the bishop already took over the role of the head or the authority figure in the church. So it was kind of easy, I guess, for Constantine to kind of take over. But that was not the intent. That is only because of our fallen nature. Our fallen nature constantly creates hierarchy, constantly creates control, constantly creates followers. Okay, there's always going to be one that's keeping things together and others that are following. And that just kind of crept into the church. And then throughout the Roman Catholic Church, that was just more and more intensified. That everything now is in the hands of the Pope or the priests. Okay? It got to the point where the Pope now was the representation of Christ, and he could make any decision he wanted, and it was correct. And it got so far that the Pope and the priests were the ones that could forgive sin. Okay? Sin, forgive sin, who only Christ or God can forgive sin. Okay? Now, do you remember that story with Jesus and the Pharisees, and Jesus forgave, I don't remember who, one of the people, either the woman or the man, he forgave the sins of that person, and the Pharisees thought it was heresy because only God can forgive. Well, Jesus could forgive too because he was God. But these people, these priests, the Pope says, well, he can forgive sin. So is he making himself God if he can do that? So here's this question. Again, this hierarchy accumulated so terribly that these people on top just took, took control. And then when the reformers came around, they were stuck in that hierarchy. They were heavily stuck in that hierarchy. It's not something that Jesus intended or Paul intended, but it just went back into the old fallen nature type mentality. So when we then get to the reformers, that hierarchy was not put away. And we continued with this hierarchy in the Reformed churches, no matter what Reformed church it was. The hierarchy continued, whether we call it priests, pastors, elders, whatever, bishops, whatever we called the top person in that church. It wasn't just the church, but it was an organization now. Okay, at this time, we're dealing with organizations. We're not dealing with an organic body. We're talking about organizations right now. Well, these people had to hold on to hierarchy. They had to hold on to hierarchy because that's what they believe. Well, that's tradition, and so we're going to have to hold on to this tradition. Somebody has to be in charge. Oh, no, we cannot let the Holy Spirit speak through every person in that body. So now, then, that hierarchy thinking took a very strong hold in the church. Now the women come along and say, well, we don't believe that, you know, the men should be on top. Women should be equal with men. But they're forgetting that we then also have to say, wait a minute, hierarchy is not it, period. We need to take out hierarchy from our church. Hierarchy shouldn't even exist in the church. Okay? But a lot of these women, they don't go that far. They only want to be able equally with men to be in leadership. Okay? And of course, when we think about leadership, what do we think about? We think about hierarchy. We think about somebody who is in leadership has authority over the other person. Okay? There is somewhat authority over when you're leading but it doesn't need to be there. When I'm leading somebody who is less capable than me, for instance, I go hiking, I know the way someplace, and the other people are following me because I know the way. Okay? Does that mean I have to be an authority? No, not really. All I have to do is I have to offer my service that I know the way better than everybody else. And we don't want to get lost. And so therefore, the other ones are temporarily submitting to me in that area only. Only in the area of leading the way, okay, on this hike. And that's the way it should be in the church as well. Yes, there can be leadership. There can be leadership in areas where the other people are not familiar, okay? But that leadership is only should only be temporary, okay? It should not be a permanent leadership. The other members should become just as informed as the leader, okay? Temporarily, they may not be informed, but they should become, the purpose of the leader should be to bring along the other people to the same level of the leader, okay? And so then that leadership is not necessary anymore, okay, in that specific area. So the way we think about leadership needs to be changed as well, radically changed, okay, radically changed. And I know that's where really the reform has failed, that we have not continued to reform everything about the church, because I really think that was very, very necessary, and it's still necessary. So again, I want to refer back to the organic church movement, where that is the case. All members are equal in that body, okay? So the reason why we still have problems with complementarianism is because we do not fully get away from that hierarchy thinking. Because once we get away from that hierarchy thinking, then what do we have? Why will we have a problem with authority? No place in the Bible tells us that the men should be in charge or in authority over the women. No place. Okay? We only hear women shouldn't be in authority over men. However, that does not exclude that men should be, therefore, in authority over women. It's not, you can't follow that. That's not a logical thinking. And that's the and that's because in the body there is really no authority. Nobody should have authority over the other person. Now, again, I have brought this up so many times, and I'm going to look it up because I have not looked it up yet. I'm going to look this verse up. And I don't know if I find it right away. Let's see. Yes. Okay, and it's in Matthew 20:25, where it says, Jesus called them together and said, "You know that the rulers of the Gentiles lorded over them, and their high official exercised authority," okay, "over them." Okay? And he says, "Not so with you. Instead, whosoever wants to become great among you must be your servant." Now, that is in the other Gospels as well. And that is the key to all the authority thinking that we have. And, you know, people don't want to see that. People do not want to see that, wait a minute, authority is not necessary anymore. Okay? We're in the church are supposed to put away this authority thinking. Again, that was in Matthew 20:26. And I'm going to read it again. Jesus called them together and said, "You know that the rulers of the Gentiles lorded over them, and their high officials exercised authority over them." Okay? That is the institutional thinking. That's the hierarchy thinking. But among you, it will be different. Okay? Whosoever wants to be a leader among you must be your servant. Okay? So, this is something we need to think about. And that's what constantly still causes a lot of confusion. If we're not rethinking our structure of the church, we cannot rethink the hierarchy that is between genders, the gender hierarchy. Okay, we will never change thinking. And if we are not breaking away, just like Luther had to break away, even though he was kicking and screaming, and the other reformers, they had to break away from the Catholic Church. See, Luther wanted to reform the Catholic Church. He did not want to break away. Okay? But you can't reform something that is so totally corrupt and totally wrong. You can't do that. Okay? You have to leave. And so it is with these churches that are still having this hierarchy thinking. They will never give up their thinking. Okay? And if they ever think, you know, that women are also in charge, they or may be in charge, then they still keep the hierarchy thinking. And the women will act like men and enforce the same hierarchy. Well, I am better than you because I went to seminary. I'm better than you because I'm a pastor. Now, nobody thinks that way, of course, out loud. But we act exactly that way. I can preach because I have a seminary degree. Okay? I can lead music because I have a seminary degree. Okay? I can do various things because I have a seminary degree. Well, I am going to lead the service because I have a seminary. No. See, that is just not the way the church needs to function. So I think that is really the crux between egalitarianism and complementarianism. We need to leave the old hierarchical institutions behind as much as we can. Now, that can only happen if we have more and more people wanting to break away. Again, I said I'm attending a church, traditional church, who has still a hierarchy in place. Why am I attending it? Because I haven't found anything different in my area. That's why. So, guess what? If we have more and more people thinking in terms of non-hierarchy, then you will have more and more churches that we can attend that don't have a hierarchy. And these people don't have a hierarchy in the church, and they don't have a hierarchy, within the gender. Within the gender. Gender doesn't have, is not affected by the hierarchy either. Okay, when we go to churches like that. So, that's the way we need to look at, is in terms of hierarchy. We need to leave places, churches who refuse to put away hierarchy. You cannot do it any other way. I mean, just constantly discussing these things and pointing out these things to people who are stuck in a hierarchy, people who are stuck, in gender inequality, they will not change. We just simply have to leave them and say, hey, you're following false teachers. Just like the Luther and the other reformers left the Catholic Church, we have to leave these old churches and say, no, that is not the way that we are going to function. Well, I'm going to finish up today. because I think this is a good place to stop. And next time, I want to talk a little bit about feminism, because I think that's another thing that I need to address before I finish this section and this topic. So I will see you next time, and stay warm because it is cold here and I can't wait for spring. I am just longing for spring to return. I'm sitting here looking outside and it's so foggy and cold, and I'm thinking, where is spring? I want spring to come. I will talk to you soon.